everyone here, before we close the day, advance ruling. Sir, what do you mean by advance ruling? Decision by the AAR or AAAR. AAR means authority for advance ruling. AAAR means appellate authority for advance ruling. Sir, there is a person. This person is basically a registered person or a person who is desirous of obtaining registration. What will he do? He can ask certain questions. What are the questions he can ask? Basically, the questions are C, advance ruling list. Sir, C means classification ka question. A means applicability of a notification. R means registration whether required or not. L means determination of liability. I for admissibility of ITC. S means whether something is resulting in supply or not. And T means determination of time of supply or value of supply. Sir, this person will go ahead and file a signed application in GST ARA01 along with a fees of 5000 rupees on the common portal. Sir, this application will go to AAR, which is a state wise or a union territory wise body. Basically, they have gone ahead and constituted AAR authority for advance ruling in every state and UT. This will now, the authority will now go ahead and forward the application to the concerned officer and call for information or records. Baba, after, who are these members? These people are members who are appointed by central government or state government who are JC or above. Now they will go ahead and examine the application plus record. They will give OBH to the applicant or his authorized representative plus concerned officer or his authorized representative, and then they have two options, either to reject the application or admit the application. Sir, when will they go ahead and reject? If question raised in the application is already pending or decided in any proceeding in case of the applicant, they will give an OBH and then reject and pass the order with reason. Sir, a copy of the rejection order shall be given to whom? Applicant, concerned officer and his jurisdictional officer. Sir, if application is admitted, what will they do? They will go ahead and ask for further details, examine the detail, then give an opportunity of being heard to the applicant or his authorized representative, concerned officer or his authorized representative. And now, if the members of AAR, authority for advance ruling, Baba, basically we are talking about these members. If this member do not have any difference in opinion, they will go ahead and pronounce the advance ruling within how many days? 90 days. Once, sir, but Baba, sir, if they have difference in opinion, both the members have difference in opinion, then what to do? Baba, if they have difference in opinion, then they can state the point of difference and file an application will be AAAR, appellate authority for advance ruling. Sir, they did not have difference in opinion, then Baba, these people have to go ahead and pronounce the advance ruling within how many days? 90 days. And a copy of advance ruling shall be given to applicant and his concerned officer. Sir, if applicant is aggrieved, he will go ahead and apply in GST ARA02 within how many days? 30 days plus an extension of 30 days can be granted to the applicant by AAAR, basically by these people. Are we clear, everyone? Sir, what is the fees if you want to go to AAAR? Basically 10,000 rupees. Sir, if the officer is aggrieved, then the officer can also go. You did not go, you are happy, officer can go. In that case, the application should go in GST ARA03 and the fees which is payable is nil. Can I go ahead, everyone? Sir, now once the application is filed with the AAAR, what will the AAAR do? AAAR will go ahead and give opportunity of being heard to the applicant or and the concerned officer. They will either confirm the original advance ruling or modify the original advance ruling and pass the order within 90 days of reference. Reference, sir, when the reference was done over here, or within 90 days of the application filed by the applicant or concerned officer, and a copy of the order to whom? Applicant, concerned officer, jurisdictional officer and the original authority for advance ruling. Sir, these people now had difference in opinion. If they have difference in opinion, advance ruling cannot be given. The applicant has one option, he can go to the court. However, for your exam purpose, you just have to write, if there is a difference between appellate authority ka member, then advance ruling cannot be issued. Sir, there were some power of authority for advance ruling also which we read, and AAAR also which we read. Basically, they can discover and inspect, for enforce attendance, examining on oath, issuing commission and compelling production of books. Basically, they have all the powers of a civil court. Sir, what else was there? Sir, if the advance ruling, sees that there is a mistake which is apparent from the record, it can be rectified within 6 months. Sir, if because of the rectification there is an increase in tax liability or reduction in input tax credit, opportunity of being heard is to be given. Sir, advance ruling shall be binding on whom? It shall be binding on applicant, concerned officer and jurisdictional officer, unless there is a change in law, fact and circumstance. Sir, I have taken an advance ruling by fraud, misrepresentation. Baba, government is selling. An advance ruling taken by misrepresentation or fraud is void ab initio. I hope you guys enjoyed the chapter of advance ruling. Have a great evening, everyone. I'll see you guys tomorrow.